a toy it is looking like a toy it is looking like a hemisphere on that cone is placed. So this is the shape of the toy. So in the question he is asking to find the height of the cone first, and also he is asking to find the total surface area of the toy. So how we will find the total surface area? We will find the curved surface area of the cone and curved surface area of the hemisphere. Finally we are going to add these two, that will give you the total surface area of the toy. So first we have to find the height of the cone. So how to find the height of the cone? He given a condition that volume of a cone is equal to 3 by 2 times the volume of hemisphere. So this is a condition he given. So with that condition we are going to find the height of the cone. So volume of a cone is nothing but 1/3 pi r square h. So volume of a hemisphere is nothing but 2 by 3 times pi r cube. Okay, 3 gets cancelled, 2 gets cancelled. So what is left here? Pi is going to cancel, remaining are 1 by 3 into r square into h, that is equal to r cube. We have to find the value of h. So send these r square and 3 to right side. So it is a fraction, r square by 3. Whenever a fraction is going to right side, it becomes reverse, 3 by r square. So r square gets cancelled, r cube gets cancelled, remaining is r here. So this is h is nothing but 3 times r cube, r into r 3 times, by r square, r into r 2 times. So remaining is r here. So this is a simplification. So in the question itself he given that radius is 7 centimeter, 7 threes are 21 centimeter is the height of the cone. So now what we have to do, we have to find curved surface area of the cone, curved surface area of the cone. Radius of the cone is given, that is 7 centimeter. So now we have to find the curved surface area of a cone, CSA. So what is the formula to calculate the curved surface area of a cone? Pi RL. So where pi means 22 by 7, r means the radius, l means the slant height. So slant height is not given in the question. So we have to find out the slant height. So first we have to find the slant height. So we know that in a right angle triangle, so it is looking like a right angle triangle, Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square is nothing but opposite side square plus adjacent side square. We know this formula. So here the opposite side is nothing but 21 square plus 7 square. It is 21 square is nothing but 441. This is nothing but 49. 7 square is nothing but 49. So the addition of these two you will get 490. So this is nothing but hypotenuse square is equal to 490 we are getting. So we have to find the value of only hypotenuse. So hypotenuse is nothing but the square is going to right side, it becomes root, under root of 490. So what we have to do, we have to find the value of 490 up to 2 decimal places. So it is not a perfect square. So what we have to do, you have to use dot method to find the value of 490. You know dot method. So I will explain the dot method here. So just you see, we have to find the square root of 490 up to 2 decimal places. So put a dot and dot after keep 4 zeros. So dot method is the best method to find out the square root of not perfect squares. So what we have to do, put a dot on the last digit, leave that, put a dot again, leave it, leave this one again, put it, leave here, put it. So see, on 4 we have a star mark, here on 0 we have a star mark, here here. You start from the last digit, put the star, leave one digit, again put the star, leave one digit, again put the star, leave one digit, again put the star. Finally, we have put a star mark on the 4. So now what we have to do, we have to see only perfect squares, like 1 into 1 is nothing but 1, 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 3 square is nothing but 9. So 2 square is 4, 3 square is more. So take 2 square, 2 2's are 4 here, 2 2's are 4, 4 minus 4 is nothing but 0. Take the next 2 digits. So 90 up to the star mark, 90. Now what you have to do here, what is the in the quotient part, 2 is there, double that 2. If you double that number, it becomes 4. If you double that 2, it becomes 4. So after that, what you have to do, if you write 1, you have to multiply with 1, so it becomes 41. If you write 2 here, if you side, if you write 2 means you should multiply with 2. It becomes 84. 4 side, if you write 3 means you have to multiply with 3. 3 3s are 9 and this is 129. 129 is more than 90. So only 2 is enough. 4 side, if I am writing 2 means I have to multiply the total number with 2. So here also you write the 2 here. So 42 into 2 is nothing but 84. Take the difference here, the difference is 6. Take next 2 digits, 0, 0, it becomes 600. Double this number, 22. 22 double is nothing but 44. 44 side, if you write 1 means you have to multiply the total number with 1. So 44 side, writing 1 means I am multiplying with 1, 4, 41. So it is closer to 600. So I am taking that number. Okay, 441. So now here subtract. So this is 5, this is 9, this is 10. 10 minus 1 is nothing but 9 here. 9 minus 4 is nothing but 5 here. 5 minus 4 is nothing but 1. Again, 2 zeros. So now here 15,900 it is. Double that, 221. What happens, 221 if you double, it becomes 442. If you write 1 here, you have to multiply with 1. If you write 2 here, you have to multiply with 2. For example, I am writing 1 means 4421. It's almost 4000 change. So approximate, it is 3 times it will go. Okay. 22.13. So 3 times how much it is, just you see, 3 3's are 9 here, okay. So 22.13, this is the approximate value of square root of 490. So 21 square is nothing but 441, 441 square root is nothing but 21, so it is 490, so it is 22.13. Okay, I hope you understood this method. So it is a dot method. We use the concept of dot method to find out the square root of not perfect squares. If it is a perfect square, we can simply do that. Already some questions I have solved, I kept in the playlist, you can see that for perfect squares. So now here slant height is nothing but 22.13. this is approx. Okay, now we have to find the value of pi r l. So pi is nothing but 22/7 into radius is nothing but 7, where l is nothing but 22.13. okay, 7 is going to cancel. 22.13 into 22 we have to do. 22.13 into 22 we have to do. So otherwise we can split like this, 2 into 11, 22.13. So 2 3s are 6, 2 1s are 2, 4 into 11. So multiplication with 11 will be simple. So what we have to do, first 4 as it is. 4 plus 4 is nothing but 8. Okay, 4 plus 2 is nothing but 6. 2 plus 6 is nothing but 8. Finally it is 6. So just you see here, 4 as it is, 4 plus 4 is nothing but 8. 4 plus 2 is nothing but 6. 2 plus 6 is nothing but 8. Finally it is 6. So point after 2 digits, 486.86. So this is a CSA, curved surface area of a cone. So approximate it is. Now what we have to do, we have to find the curved surface area of a hemisphere. We have to find the curved surface area of a hemisphere. What is the formula to calculate the curved surface area of a hemisphere? Is nothing but 2 pi r square. So where 2, this is nothing but 22 by 7. Radius is nothing but 7 square. So 2 into 22 by 7 into 7 into 7, this is. Okay, 7, 7 is going to cancel. So what is left? 2 into, write this 2 into 11. This is 7. So 4 7s are 28. 28 into 11. So that is nothing but 2. This is 2 plus 8 is 10. 308. 308. So we need total surface area. What we have to do? Add that curved surface area of a cone plus CSA of a cone. Total surface area is nothing but curved surface area of a cone, that is nothing but 486.86 plus 308. Okay, 308. Add these two. Okay, this is nothing but 4 here, this is 1, 9, this is 7, 794.86. this is approx up to 2 decimal places. So if you do up to 3 decimal places, the answer will be slight difference. So in the question itself is asking only up to 2 decimal places, so that is 794.86. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe our channel for regular updates. Share this information with your friends.